Hi everyone, my name is Ed Jose Roque, and on today's episode of Clear House Office, I'm touching on Zulu Mkhathi. GQ's Best Dressed Men 2017. I feel like the man's got a very expressive sense of fashion taste, mostly because I also feel like it suits his character so much, but most of the time he looks, or he gives me the idea that he's always styled. We haven't really seen him in his comfort zone. Most of the pictures that I see of him on social media are always themed, if I should call it that. It always looks like there's a stylist behind most of the looks that he puts on Instagram. I like how he combines his colors. I'll give him a plus there. He's very perfect. He dresses very well for the occasion. He picks the right colors for every occasion. Got your tongue fat, track got you sprung, now you hum. Do you feel me? Dumb, dumb, diddy, it's a me. Attempt to reach. He has confidence in his clothes. He has confidence in his clothes, which is one of the things that I believe help him be able to pull off whatever look that he spots on that night, or that he feels like he wants to. But I have a problem with his jeans are too tight. His clothes are always so tight, and I'd actually love to see him show us a different type of style. Like, I'd love to see him show us that he's comfortable in his fashion space. What I mean by that is, I don't want to always feel like he puts in effort to dress up. I want him to give us a feeling that, okay, I've been doing this for so long. I'm GQ, one of GQ's best dressed men, 2017. I've been recognized at the Abrin's Fashion and Style Awards, and I've been doing this for a couple of years, since the Dream Team days. And I want him to show us the comfort that comes with all that experience. Like, I'd like to challenge him to actually take control. Run it up, gun cock, black mask and gloves. If you ain't got a penny, mind and blood, no love waiting for my food. I really can't wait for him to show us different styles, that he can wear different styles, not just skinny. Skinny is the perfect fit for him, I must give him that. Skinny is the perfect fit for him, but he can go a different type of skinny. There's like carrot fit pants, not always pencil. I've never seen him in a t-shirt. I'd like to see him rock those a bit. The shirts look good on him. Let's not take that away from him. His formal wear is so, he looks so good. His suits are always tailored to the best fit, and I must give him the thumbs up for that. But because he commented and told Clear House Office that he is one of South Africa's best dressed men, and well, I agree with it. I agree with him totally that he said to Clear House Office that he's probably one of South Africa's most best dressed men. I agree with him totally, but I'd like to challenge him as well. I'd like to see him spot a different look. I'd like to see him challenge himself a bit more when it comes to his style and taste and fashion. I mean, he travels a lot, so he must have gotten a lot of influence or learned different cultures from the traveling, which also come with different styles, and that he should blend into his style, his personal style. I mean, now that winter is coming up, maybe we'll see him spot a different look, maybe a Russian look or some type of cold look. Yeah. his other important factors. I know he had a deal with Topman. I think that was in 2017. I love that. And then now, one of the best deals that I think he's got is the Daniel Wellington deal, the watches. I think he's going to take that a bit. He's going to do well with it. I'd like to hear your opinions as well on your favorite celebrities, fashion sense and taste. So make sure you follow Clayhouse Office on Twitter, Instagram, and of course, subscribe to the channel Clayhouse Office on YouTube. Time for the gospel tale. Ghetto gospel, that is. Listen. Rotten black cotton in God's eyes.